Ivanovic on one more. It's John Terry! Yay! Three!
As one of England's most famous footballers, John Terry made millions of pounds captaining Chelsea to 5 Premier League titles. Like many sports stars, he invested that money in a property empire, building mansions in Surrey. In 2014, Terry sold one of his houses for £16 million to a spy chief from the repressive Middle East state of Oman, General al-Naamani, who reportedly bought it on behalf of the country's unelected ruler, Sultan Qaboos. Terry made a £10 million profit on the sale. The Sun said, the Omani royal family wanted the house at any cost. The Sultan made him an offer he couldn't refuse. When Qaboos died last year, General al-Naamani led the funeral procession and announced on state TV that the Sultan's cousin was the heir to the throne of this secretive Gulf kingdom. Although Oman had a new Sultan, al-Naamani remained in post as Royal Office Minister, controlling the country's intelligence agencies, meeting often with British military chiefs, and keeping his name on land registry records for John Terry's old property in Surrey.
This is the back of General al-Naamani's property. He has a huge amount of land behind the house, behind the £16 million 9-bedroom mansion.
Last month, a series of protests swept through Oman as anger erupted over rising unemployment and alleged corruption among senior members of the regime. Questions were asked about how al-Naamani supposedly managed to afford a large villa outside the Omani town of Badia, as protesters called for him to be fired for allegedly using the country's resources to personally enrich himself. General al-Naamani's forces responded rapidly. Legions of riot police and lines of armoured vehicles flooded into Badia to quell the protests. In other towns, tear gas was fired and scores of people were arrested across the country. Even those who criticised the regime on social media were summoned to police stations and interrogated by the Internal Security Service, Oman's domestic spy agency, which General al-Naamani oversees. Multiple sources have told Declassified they were only released if they signed a document promising not to speak out again. We wanted to find the general to ask him some questions.
So this is a house that belongs to General al-Naamani. I can see there's a car inside. There's a number to phone.
Hello?
Oh, hi. My name's Phil Miller. I'm a journalist from Declassified UK. I'm trying to speak to General al-Naamani, who I understand is the owner of White Lakes and Oxshott.
Yeah, would you like it?
Is he available to answer a few questions about the property?
Because he's not here at the moment.
Ah, okay.
He's in Oman.
He's in Oman, okay.
Yeah, all right.
Are you his, do you work for his staff in the house?
Yeah, okay. I'm the staff.
Okay. Right, so that was a member of General al-Naamani's staff who we just spoke to there. He says that the general himself is currently in Oman, so he's not available to give us an interview now, but we'll leave this letter with various questions for him. And I understand his staff will take it. So this is the house, the White Lakes house, that was bought from John Terry, the England footballer, for £16 million.
Salaries of government ministers and senior army officers are not published in Oman, making it almost impossible to know how much al-Naamani gets paid and giving rise to serious questions about how he managed to afford such an expensive property. It would take the average Omani around 1600 years to earn enough money. Even though the general was in Oman, his house in Surrey was clearly being well looked after. While we waited outside, a chef opened the side gate to speak to an energy contractor, and a catering van delivered food.
This just shows you how the senior officials in Oman's unelected regime, in a country where all political parties are banned, is able to afford a house like this in Surrey, next to some of Britain's most famous and successful footballers. And this seems to be where the money from countries like Oman is ending up. Meanwhile, the cost of living and taxes are going up in Oman, and people feel that their wealth is being stolen from them and being used by the richest people in Oman to buy properties like this in England.